Come on, Mia. You got this. Eye on the ball.
Strike one.
Oh, man. Oh, hey there, Mathletes. You made it just in time. You got this, Mia.
Strike two.
No. Mia's team practiced so hard, but their opponent is really good. It's the last inning of the game, and Mia's team is down by one. The bases are loaded, but they already have two outs, and Mia only has one more chance before the game is over. If she gets another strike, she'll be out, and that'll be it for the game. This pitcher is throwing fireballs. Maybe if we could help Mia determine how fast the ball is moving, she'll be able to time her swing and get a hit. Okay, the distance from the pitcher's mound to home plate is 14 and 21 thousandths meters. And according to my watch, it's been taking the ball around 68 hundredths of a second to get from the pitcher to home plate. If we knew how many meters the ball traveled per second, we could help Mia time her swing. Hey, wait. Meters per second. That sounds like a division problem. What equation should we use to determine the speed of the ball? Pause here to jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. I got it. We can divide the distance in meters by the time in seconds to calculate the speed of the ball. Seems like we'll need to divide some decimals to figure this out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to solve division equations with decimal dividends and divisors. We've got to help Mia get this hit, so let's get going. Let's take a moment to review what we've already learned about dividing decimals. Let's use the equation 92 and 71 hundredths divided by 8. Go ahead and solve this warm-up division equation, rounding your answer to the nearest thousandth. Because we're rounding to the thousandths place, we can stop dividing when we get to the 10,000ths. After rounding, our answer is approximately 11 and 589 thousandths. Feel free to pause here if you'd like to compare your work to what's on screen. Great job on the warm-up problem. To divide decimals, we need to be sure to keep track of that decimal point and make sure our numbers stay organized while completing our long division. These skills can help us calculate the speed at which the ball is traveling in Mia's game. So, we need to divide 14 and 21 thousandths by 68 hundredths. Wait a second. A divisor with a decimal? What a curveball! In the warm-up problem, the dividend was a decimal and the divisor was a whole number, but what should we do if the divisor is a decimal too? We need to figure out how to divide when the divisor has a decimal. Let's check out the example problem 21 divided by 3 tenths. If we started the long division process with a decimal, like 3 tenths, we run into trouble pretty quickly. How many groups of 3 tenths can be made from two ones? That's just kind of difficult for me to visualize. Groups of 3 tenths? Do we have any strategies that could help us make this decimal easier to work with? What if we changed our divisor to a whole number? If we multiply 3 tenths by a factor of 10, we could change its place value. 3 tenths times 10 makes our new divisor 3 ones. But how do you think that's going to affect our answer? We can't just multiply one part of the equation by 10 and solve. We'll need to change another part of the equation to keep it all balanced. Remember how division can also be written in fraction form? If we rewrite this problem as 21 over 3 tenths, and then multiply 3 tenths by 10, this new fraction is no longer equivalent. In this new fraction, we would be dividing with a divisor that's 10 times bigger. That would cause our answer to be 10 times smaller than the actual answer. So what should we do? In order to make an equivalent fraction, we need to multiply the numerator, which is our dividend, by 10 as well. This new fraction, 210 over 3, is equivalent to 21 over 3 tenths. So how does that help us with our division problem? Well, if these fractions are equivalent, that means these two division problems are equivalent. And if both equations are equivalent, then their answers will be the same. Now that we've got a whole number divisor and an equivalent equation, we're ready to solve. Pause here to divide 210 by 3. And our answer is 70. Great work. Let's try this with another problem. 9 and 748 thousandths divided by 12 hundredths. Our divisor, 12 hundredths, needs to be changed to a whole number. We can rewrite this problem as the fraction 9 and 748 thousandths over 12 hundredths.
Pause here to multiply by a power of 10 to make the divisor a whole number. Don't forget to do the same to the dividend so you end up with an equivalent fraction.
To change 12 hundredths to a whole number, we need to multiply by 100, which gives us 12. Then we need to do the same thing to the dividend. 9 and 748 thousandths times 100 is 974 and 8 tenths. 974 and 8 tenths becomes our new dividend, and 12 becomes our new divisor. Because these fractions are equivalent, so are these equations. Now that we have equivalent equations with a whole number divisor, we can divide. Pause here to solve, rounding your answer to the nearest hundredth. After completing the long division process, we're left with 81.233 repeating, which you can round to 81 and 23 hundredths. Remember, you can always pause if you'd like to compare your work to the work on the screen.
Pitcher's about to throw their next pitch. Let's get to work on our speed calculation.
We want to calculate the speed of the ball in meters per second. So we need to divide 14 and 21 thousandths meters by 68 hundredths of a second. Pause here to solve by creating an equivalent equation with a whole number divisor and rounding your answer to the nearest tenth. I'll get ready to run to the dugout to tell Mia while you crunch the numbers. To create an equivalent equation, we can multiply the divisor and dividend by 100 to create an equivalent equation where the divisor is a whole number. That makes our new divisor 68 and our new dividend 1,402 1/10. Because we need our answer rounded to the nearest tenth, we need to divide until our answer has a digit in the hundredths place. 1 is less than 5, so the 6 in the tenths place does not change. Feel free to pause if you'd like to compare your work to the work displayed here. The pitcher is throwing approximately 20 and 6 tenths meters per second. I'll go tell Mia now. Thanks to your hard work, Mia hit a home run and her team won the game! And you learned that divisors with decimals can be converted to whole numbers using factors of 10. Division equations can be converted to equivalent equations by multiplying the divisor and dividend by the same factor of 10. And equivalent division equations result in equal solutions. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go along with this lesson, because, like Mia, with some practice, you'll be hitting division home runs in no time. See you next time! Hey.